In this video, we're going to look at how to graph circles, trig functions, and other conics. To graph a circle, select the circle tool and click the center point to start the graph, and then drag to set a second point that is somewhere on the circle. If you need to clear out the graph, you can drag one of these points outside of the drawing area and release, and that will clear the graph. Alternatively, you can click the Clear All button to clear all the graphs that are being currently drawn. You graph an ellipse a similar way. You click first to set the center point, and then you'll notice that the second point defines a box around the ellipse. So you can use this point to define the major and minor axes. To graph a trig function, there are two trig function graphing types you can use. The first here, you'll notice you're going to be setting the maximum and minimum values of the function. This is very handy for graphing a cosine function, where you know the highest value, you know the lowest value, and then you can adjust the position so that the period is correct. The second type of trig function, you set a point at the midline and a point at the maximum or minimum. This is very handy for graphing a sine function, where you usually know the starting point at the midline, and then you can adjust the amplitude and period accordingly. For other conics, you can use the other graphing tools. We have the parabola tool, where you first graph the vertex and then a second point on the graph. There's a horizontal parabola, where you graph again the vertex and then a second point on the graph. This is again opening left or right rather than up or down. And then we have the hyperbola tools, where in both the cases, you're going to be first placing the point where the asymptotes would meet. So this is sort of the center point of the hyperbola. And then you select a second point based on the major and minor axes of the hyperbola. This first tool is for vertical hyperbolas, and the second tool here is for horizontally opening hyperbolas. Finally, some questions may ask you to graph vectors, and for that you can use this vector tool, where you simply click on the first base point of the vector, this will be at the tail, and then drag your second point to where you want the head of the vector to point. Again, if you need to clear out one graph, you can select one of the control points and drag it outside the drawing area, and that will delete the curve. And if you need to clear everything, click Clear All.